Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. It's been a while since I shot my last roll of film and it absolutely sucks hanging around at home without doing anything creative. Yes, I filmed a bunch of videos in the last months, but finally it's time to get back out there. In the next couple of weeks, I will be on the road filming videos and doing all sorts of cool things. Since I'm still in the planning phase, I'm not 100% sure what cameras I should bring and also what film stocks would be nice to feature in upcoming videos. But before I go into more detail, let me show you this here. I announced a new X-Pan zine roughly a month ago and unfortunately things took longer than expected. But finally, yes, finally I can show you the actual zine instead of the first one. And now, since I'm already talking about the zine, a huge thank you goes out to each and every one of you who pre-ordered this. Without you, this would have not been possible. The last couple of months have been a total mess and up until I announced it, I wasn't sure if I should make a new zine or not. And even if you didn't pre-order it, only by watching my videos, giving me feedback and input over the last years, also massively helped me to make this possible. Because without this community, a lot of the photos in here wouldn't even exist. So like I've mentioned before, thank you to each and every one of you. By the time you're watching this video, some of you have probably already received their copies. On the outside, it looks very similar to the first version that came out 2 years ago, and I kept the shiny title, which gives the zine a really, really nice touch. Obviously, on the inside, it has changed a lot, because all the images are brand new, and on top of that, it has more pages and a lot more photos. Another thing that I also kept is a list with all the used film stocks and places where the photos were taken. I would love to show you much more, but I don't want to spoil it too much. Hopefully you will all receive your orders soon and you can have a look for yourself. At the moment, shipping, especially intercontinental shipping, seems to take a little longer than usually, but I guess this is because of limited air traffic right now. But fingers crossed, it won't take too long. And if you want a copy too, you will find a link in the description box below this video. Alright, now let's get back to what I was talking about in the beginning of the video. So like I've said before, I will be going on a road trip and I will be on a sailing boat for 1 week. I did something similar last year in Thailand and some of you might have seen the videos. There I used the Leica M6 with a 28mm lens and the only film that I shot was Kodak Ektar 100 and I think that worked very well. However, this time I want to involve you in the whole process. And I want you to decide which camera or cameras I should use and also what film stock or film stocks. Please don't post a comment with your recommendation yet. Let me explain first how this is going to work. There are three cameras and lenses possible. And the first one is of course the Leica M6 with a 28mm Summicron. And the second camera that is possible is the Hasselblad X-Pan with a 45mm lens. And last but not least, the Nikon FM2 with a Voigtländer 58 1.4. Now the film stocks. Number one would be the Kodak Vision 3 by Silbersalz. These are different film stocks, but they have a kind of similar look. And this here would probably be my number one choice for this trip because I simply like the look a lot. All right, number two is, of course, Kodak Ektar 100. And that worked very well in Thailand and maybe also on this trip would work, up to you. And number three, that would be Kodak Gold 200, which is a really nice budget film stock. Some people like it, some people don't. I kind of like it. Another budget option was this one here, which is Aqua Vista 400. Unfortunately, it has been discontinued, so that's why I only have two rolls left and it's only, I think it's, is it 24? I think it's only 24 frames, so I only have these two rolls, so yeah. But it's a really nice film and I really like it, and at one point I have to shoot it, so if you want me to shoot this, let me know. Up to the next one and film number five, and that is Kodak Portra 400. I mean, who doesn't like Portra? It's a really nice film. That is also an option, so this is number 5. And number 6 is a film that is kind of similar to Portra, because it's this, but in 120 it's a film I really like. But in 35mm I haven't shot it a lot, and most people don't. I think Portra is more popular, I guess. And that would be Fuji Pro 400H. This is number 6. All right, let's continue with number 7, and this is this one here. It's I think not many people are familiar with this. This is Superior Premium 400. I think it's more available in Asia and especially in Japan, so it's really hard to get this in Europe, and if you can get it, it's really expensive. So yeah, also on, I think here I also have only 2 rolls, but if you want to see this, let me know. This is Fuji Superior Premium 400, and it's number 7. All right, let's move on to number 8, and number 8 is a film that I really like. I have shot it quite a bit in 35mm, and it's really great, and that is this one here. It's Lomography 800. It's a really nice film, and especially in low light, it's pretty good. So yeah, it's a good alternative for Portra 800. Not as nice as Portra 800, but much cheaper, so that would also be a good option, and it's number 8. And I also want to throw in 2 black and white films. Color makes probably much more sense, but these 2 film stocks could be interesting nevertheless. And the first one is a brand new film, and it was sent over to me from Lomography, and that is this one here. It's Babylon 13. It's a super low ASA film. The ASA, like the name suggests, is 13, so yeah, I mean, I should have plenty of light to shoot this, and so far what I've seen, the photos look really interesting, really nice contrast, so this should be a good option to shoot and to try out, and this would be number 9. And last but not least, there's 1 film stock left, also black and white, and number 10, that is Rolly Retro ADS. It's a really nice black and white film, very contrasty, and because it's very sensitive to infrared light, it might be a cool option to shoot, especially if I'm on a sailing boat out on the sea. This could look really nice, so this would also be a great option. And that is number 10. All right, let me explain how the voting works. Your comment should look like this. First, you vote for a camera, and here you can vote for one or a combination of 2 cameras. For example, if you want me to only use 1 camera, then only mention one of those cameras I showed you before. However, if you think I should rather split it to 2 different cameras, then mention your 2 favorites. For instance, the Nikon FM2 and X-Pan. For film stocks, it will work very similar. If you want me to use a single film stock, then simply mention the number of your favorite one from the 10 that I showed you earlier. But if you want me to shoot different film stocks, then you can pick 3 out of the 10. But if you want me to shoot all of them and you want to see more than just 3, then just mention mix, and I will try at least to shoot 1 of each. All right, after 1 week, I will go through all the comments and I will crunch the numbers and will let you know the results over on Instagram and also here on YouTube in the community tab. All right, guys, that's it for today's video. I'm looking forward to your votings, and we'll hopefully see each other again very soon in the next one. Until then, auf Wiedersehen.